One of the funnest areas you will ever operate in your life is also one of the scariest when you have to deal with new creativity. I'm talking kingdom creativity. I'm talking about explosive creativity. Do you know how I'm so creative? My wife, my daughters, Malachi and Judah, and we hire the right people. I'm not super creative, but I have a creative team around me that helps me. I have people that help me with our videos and our books and different things. Your creativity should not be limited to just you, because God has called you to walk in His favor, His blessing, and when that anointing is upon you, He is going to give you the ability to be super creative to reach more people for the kingdom of God. Proverbs 22:29. If you are uniquely gifted in your work, you will rise and you will be promoted. You won't be held back and you will stand before kings. If you are uniquely gifted in your work, if you are, it's on you. It's not on God. So many people sit around and say, God, will you bless me? God, will you promote me? God, will you help me? And they're putting everything on God. But God has already given you gifts, talents, and abilities and anointing. I can't tell you how many people in our mentoring program that I have said, hey, you're wanting God to do all of this. He has already given you everything that you need. And I speak prophetically into their life. And I'll say, if you will just move forward, watch what happens. And then they start moving forward in what God has called them to. And an explosion of creativity hits them, their life, their ministry, their business, their family. And everything starts to happen after that moment right there. God is, listen, people always say, I'm waiting on God. God's waiting on you. Romans 12, verse 6. God's marvelous grace imparts to each one of us different gifts and ministries that are uniquely ours. Nobody can do what you do. Nobody can do it how you do it. You know, a lot of times in life, people may try to imitate you and be like you, but they can never duplicate you because the gifts, talents, and abilities that you have are uniquely yours. You may get some great creative ideas from other people, but you have to move according to the Spirit of the Lord and do what He has called you to do. In this day and age, there is no 100% blueprint you can follow to be successful. You are going to have to get that determined by the power of the Holy Spirit. 1 Timothy 4:14, don't minimize the powerful gift that operates in your life. There are so many people who are whining and praying, mainly whining, about what they can do with their life and how come this isn't working, how come that isn't working. But you know what? They have minimized every single thing that God has called them to do. They're not moving in their gifts. They're not moving in their talents. I remember one day I saw this young man who I knew 5 years prior, and he was such an inspiration to be around. He was so gifted and so talented. And every time you see him, he was always dressed nice and he was always taking care of his health. And then I saw him and he was in an old beat up vehicle. He was just wearing old wrinkled clothes. His health wasn't in check. And I said, man, what's going on? And he said, oh, he just started telling me a sad story. And he said, about 4 years ago, I lost my creative edge in life. So I gave up all my hopes and dreams. And he said, literally, I got a dead-end job that just pays my bills. And I said, that's not the young man that I knew 5 years ago. So I started speaking into his life. I started encouraging him. And you know what? In just a few short months, he was back on his feet going again. He walked away from his creativity that God had put inside of him. He lost that edge to push forward. He minimized every prophetic word and gift that God put on his life. How many people are like that? How many people just need encouragement, somebody to help them? Colossians 3:23, put your heart and soul into every single activity that you do as though you were doing it for the Lord himself and not merely for others. Now, I'm going to say something that a lot of people may not understand. But I tell people sometimes when you're looking for an occupation or a job, maybe you shouldn't think about your benefits and your pay as much as what am I going to learn while I'm there. A lot of times people are wanting to create a certain type of business or ministry. I tell people maybe you should work for somebody for a year or two before you start your own. I remember one time I was talking to a young man who has a very vibrant, powerful ministry, and he was getting ready to make his next big move in life. And he said, you know, I'm thinking about coming to your church, but I'm not for sure if I should. And I said, I know why you would come to our church. You would sit under me for 18 months to 2 years, and then I would turn around and launch you out. And you don't know if you want to do that or just start now. He said, yeah, I think I want to start now, but will you mentor me along the way? And I said, yes. And so this gentleman got two mentors. He got me. I'm big on prayer, fasting, revival. And another guy is really part of the other side of having a church, we'll say. And so he was gleaning from both of us. And out of creativity of what he learned, he didn't copy, but he learned both sides, and he would move forward with how he felt he was supposed to run his church. A lot of times in life, people fail because they don't have a mentor. They don't have somebody in their life. God is calling us to be creative. Tap into the Lord. There are so many resources in the world that you can find. You can be mentored by people. You can go online, and you can find people to help you to be creative. And the reason that is important, because we are in a season like I've never seen before in my life. I have never seen such an anointing on the children of God to build right now. My fivefold ministry gift is I am an apostle that's very prophetic. And so I love building, and we are going to see people build with an explosive power of the Holy Spirit behind them. 1 Peter 4:10, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards of God's grace in its various forms. What would the world look like if everybody that was close to you was walking in explosive creativity with the Holy Spirit? The world would be vibrant. The world would be changed. But people are not building with their creativity. That scripture says that everybody should use the gift that they have received. Your gift should be so evident upon your life that everybody should know what you do. Instead of you telling people what you can do, your fruit out of your creativity, and you build upon your creativity, is what will open up the door for everything that you need. And your gift will be a blessing as you build according to it to everybody in the kingdom of God. Psalms 37:5-6, commit your way to the Lord, trust in him, and he will do this. He will make sure your righteous reward shines like the dawn, your vindication like the noonday sun. When you commit your gift to God and you build according to the gifts, callings, abilities, and talents God has given you, he is going to make a way for you, and you are going to be able to build like you have never been able to build in your life. I just feel that God is waiting on us to tap into our prophetic words and build according to the Spirit of the Lord. Titus 3:14, our people must learn to devote themselves to doing what is good in order to provide for urgent needs and not live unproductive lives. If you are struggling financially, it is because you are not building according to the complete and perfect will that God has for your life, and you are not using all your gifts, talents, and abilities. I'll never forget the time I was doing a counseling with this young couple, and they loved each other. It wasn't marriage counseling. They just couldn't understand why they were struggling so bad financially. As I was talking to them, the wife said, "You know, my husband, he had a very minimum type of easy job." And she said, "But he is so gifted and talented." And I looked at him and I said, "Well, what can you do?" He said, "Well," and she said, "Let me answer that." And she rattled off three things that was the polar opposite of what he was doing. And his face kind of lit up. He said, "I love doing those things." And I said, "Well, what if I help you to get rolling in those things? Would you be willing to go on a business adventure with me?" He said, "Oh, yeah, I'd love to." Then he looked at her and she said, "Don't you start on me." He said, "Oh, you done told on me. I'm going to tell on you." And he told me what she did. And I said, "I would have never guessed that." She said, "Yeah, I'm really good at it, but," and she gave some excuses. I said, "Well, what if we jump in with you and help you?" She said, "Okay." In 90 days, their income had more than doubled. You know what else had doubled? The smiles on their face. They were doing what they were created to do. They started building according to the things of the Lord. Sometimes you just need people to be around you to push you in the right way. Proverbs 4:7, "Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and in all you're getting, get understanding." You can get understanding and wisdom from the Word of God. That's why you need to be a student of the Word. You also can get wisdom and understanding from prophetic words from God. It will make things clear. Also, you can have a mentor, a pastor, apostle, prophet in your life that can help you understand better what you're called to do and how to walk in the things that He has called you to do. Whenever I'm lacking in any area of my life, I don't complain. I don't get negative, and I don't make excuses. Do you know the more excuses you make, none of it helps you get your bills paid anymore? The more excuses you make, it adds no joy to you or anybody around you. But when you get wisdom and you get understanding, everything will start to fall into place. Matthew 7:12, "In everything you do, be careful to treat others in the same way that you want them to treat you." Never look down on somebody because they're in a low spot. We've all been in a low spot. But when you see that person in a low spot, if you put a 10 over their head and see what they could become, you help them. When you're in a low spot, God will bring somebody alongside you to help you, to be a benefit to what you're doing. Philippians 4:19, "I am convinced that my God will satisfy every need that you have, for I have seen the abundant riches of glory revealed to me through the anointing one, Jesus Christ." Every single need that you have, God will supply all your needs. You can even get to a place that He will grant you every single want that you have. If you're taking care of the kingdom of God, and you're moving forward with the things of the kingdom, everything in your life will fall into place. Everything will start to happen to you, and everything will start to happen for you. I've never seen the righteous forsaken. I have seen the abundance upon the children of God, that things happen to them and for them at a pace that you can't even understand, because God is a good, merciful, and grateful and graceful God. Proverbs 16:9. "Within your heart you can make plans for the future, but the Lord chooses the steps that you will take to get there." It's just like that lady on your phone when you type in an address and your GPS tells you which way to go. Don't try to figure it out. Follow the voice. Follow the way. And when you do that, things work out. I'm telling you, when God gives you a vision, you think you know the path, God will show you the path that will make you better. A lot of people in life want everything easy. That doesn't make true champions. To thrive in life, you need to go down the path that is less traveled. You need to go down the path of adventure. Okay? When you move forward, God can do what He needs to do in you and through you when you build according to the kingdom of God. See, what most people believe is God gives them a prophetic word. They actually think the prophetic word or the promise from God is the end result. It is not. It's actually secondary. The primary thing is who you become on the journey. See, while you're moving forward for that prophetic word, who you become is a better thing. Example, God gives me a book to write. I write the book. It blesses thousands of people. But who I become in the journey of writing the book makes me a better person. After every single book that I've ever written, I've become a more powerful person because the Lord has done so much inside of me. Matthew 12:33. You must determine if a tree is good or rotten. You can recognize good trees by their delicious fruit. But if you find rotten fruit, you can be certain that the tree is rotten. The fruit defines the tree. I love seeing people that I haven't seen in 6 months to a year, and they say, "Wow, Joe, you have changed." Thank you. I love seeing friends that I'm like, "Man, I see you winning in life, growing with God, fulfilling your kingdom mandate." It's because we've allowed God to do what He needs to do. When you walk in explosive favor, explosive anointing, explosive creativity, you will automatically build with an explosive power of God.